I'm closing chapters. I'm turning pages.
Well, greetings, family. This is Pastor Ren, and I'm honored to give you your midday motivation. Might I suggest to you that there is a miracle in your house? That's right. I want to say there is a miracle in your house. There's a story in 2 Kings chapter 4 where Elijah comes and finds this widow woman. And he says something to her that's very interesting. Listen at this. In verse number 3, Elijah tells her, go borrow some vessels. Here is the criteria, he says. Do not borrow a few. Think about it. He says, go borrow some vessels, but don't borrow a few. I'll come to that in a moment, but there's a wonderful statement, very profound, that was made by Harry Emerson Foster years ago, and where he states, and I quote, God is not our cosmic bellhop. Here is what he was saying, unquote. He does not do everything we want him to do. No. I can't just send a praise up and demand God come and do something. Because if that was the case, then he would cease to be God. But God has to have the power to tell me no where no is needed and tell me yes where yes is needed. He has to be God regardless of how I feel and what I say, unless I'm speaking his word, not my word, but his word. And so what Foster was trying to get us to understand was God does not just wait on us hand and foot. He's given us everything. The word tells us that pertains to life and godliness. But sometimes there's some things we must do because there is a blessing in participating in the miracle. Can I say that again? Sometimes God will do things for us. Other times God wants to partner with us. That was a miracle. Here is what Elijah said to her. Go borrow some vessels, but don't borrow a few. Now my question is, what is a few? Think about that for a moment. What is a few? If I was to ask that question, somebody would say, well, a few is 3. Somebody else may say a few is 4. A few is 5. Well, it does not give a criteria. Here is what I believe. Her faith level determined how many she borrowed. He says, go borrow some vessels, but don't borrow a few. So I cannot be upset at my brother or my sister, because both of us got the same instructions. If I decided to expand my faith and put my faith out there, and a few for me may be 1,000, a few for you may be 1,000,000. Whatever your few is, don't be defined and confined by what somebody else's definition of a few is, because the word tells us that when she came in and shut the door, she began to pour the oil. And as long as she had vessels to receive, the oil kept flowing. When did it stop, Pastor Ian? It stopped when she ran out of vessels to receive. In other words, it stopped when she no longer had the capacity to hold what God was trying to give her. Can I say this to us? Heaven has so much that it wants to unleash into our lives. The real question is, do you have the capacity to receive? So when God tells me you want a 1-car garage, I want to give you a 3. Do you have the faith to go after it? When he says, give me some, what is your sum? Is it what the next person's is? Because if I do what they do, I'll receive what they receive. I must be willing to put my faith out there and must be willing to tell somebody, your few may be 5, but don't be angry at me if my few is multiplied in the thousands. Or the thousands. You get the picture. I'm trying to tell us that the oil would have kept flowing even to this day had she kept borrowing vessels, because he can only give us according to our capacity to receive. My question for you today is, there is a miracle in your house. Do you know where it is? Do you know how to access it? Try partnering with God today to receive the miracle you've been praying for. I believe it's going to take place. And I just want you to know, I love you, we're praying for you. And it's time for us to get up and build the kingdom, one person at a time. Let's build. I am forgetting what's behind me. I have finally decided I'll be moving on.